presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with all love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you make it a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you'll learn to have the perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 52, NASDAQ down 10, S&P's flat, gold contract down $62, trading $19.50 an ounce. Silver off $1.15, $26.92 an ounce. Light sweet crude, flat, $42.91 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year down one at 139.11, 30-year off a half a point at 178.10, and King Dollar. King Dollar's up 618 ticks, trading 92.887. King Dollar's going back inside its higher range once again. We'll see whether it holds. Euro. Euro's at 118. The yen is out here at 105.94, and the British pound is at 131 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, bottom line is that we got to another all-time high in all the indices. S&P up here got to 33.95. Right now, you're at 33.86. And what you had here is it was all about when the Fed minutes come out, folks. The bottom line, both the S&Ps as well as the NASDAQ futures came down fast and furious. The S&Ps got from a price point of 33.95, went down to 33.76. Bottom line, you get a high volume high down here. I expect we're going to see it before coming into the close. And what that was all about is that it was what wasn't inside of those minutes, folks. And what wasn't inside of them is that the amount of treasuries that they're actually going to buy back. So bottom line, it spooked the market a bit. The NQs went from a price point of 11,430 down to 11,311. And bottom line is that you get a high volume high there too, you know. And you can see we had a high volume high this morning, folks, at 10:30. That was laying out there first at the NQs, which is 11,332, gets all the way up to a new high, 11,438, and then just comes back down. And that is with Apple still in the green, folks, okay? Apple right now is trading up $3.31. Apple did hit a market cap today at 10:30 this morning of $2 trillion. If you're watching my screen right now, it's set up as 1.990.20, but the bottom line is that that did hit the $2 trillion mark. Silver, let's go take a look at the silver market out here. As the dollar climbed higher, bottom line, silver goes south. And what you have out here is this, is that the silver market right now, you're backing down with 203,000 contracts. You're backing into 335,000 contracts as well as 242. So the bottom line is that this is building cars for higher price. Gold contract, they whacked the gold contract too. Gold contract is down $60 to $70, $60 right now. And what you're going to see here, we got a low inside the gold contract today of 19, that's weird, GC, active contract. Oh, yeah. No, I see what's going on. Yeah, that's right. So we got a low out here of 1941 today. Bottom line is you're down on 415,000 contracts, and you're coming into 560 as well as 460. 560 and 460. So bottom line is I expect you're going to get a little bit lower out here tomorrow, more than likely, inside of both those metals markets. More than likely, what you're going to see is a rejection of lower price. Now, let's go over to King Dollar. So King Dollar got a bounce going. The bounce was going prior to the 2 o'clock. Let me show you how this was set up. So what you had out here is that starting at, really 10 o'clock this morning, at 9 o'clock, at 10 o'clock this morning, King Dollar started making its move, had a big move when the Fed minutes come out. That's when we went from a price point of 92.684 up to 92.718. The number to keep your eye on here inside of King Dollar is the 92.546. It looks to me like you're going to finish over that. If you finish over that, then it's going to try to get up into the last two swing points that we had out there, which was on the 3rd of August as well as the 12th of August. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We're going to take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today. You got American Airlines up 11 cents. You got, Bank of America is up 16. You got United Airlines. That gave it up. That was up $2.50 this morning. It's only up 65 cents. Target is the big number. Target, folks, came out with monster numbers, up $17.30. They've never grown so fast in their whole corporate history. Monster move. There's no two ways about that. Pinterest down 57 cents. TJ X off $3.28. After the close today, the big dog after the close today is going to be NVIDIA, folks. NVIDIA is going to be coming out with numbers after the close today. NVIDIA has been a one-way trip on the way up. That's how it loves to trade. In March, it was $188. And its bottom line is it's $300 higher than that. No, $200. No. Yeah, $300 higher than that in 6 months. let's see what they're going to basically come in with. So they're looking to come in with $3.7 billion and $1.97 to the bottom line. We'll see where this baby shakes out, but that has certainly been climbing up in an extraordinary way. There's no two ways about that. We go take a look at the composite, the NASDAQ composite. So the composite also got to an all-time high out here today, and we just backed down slightly. We 11,257. That was the high. Yesterday, the high was 11,230. Right now, you're at 11,196. Stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento. Larry's going to be doing a live trading workshop. You can be right in that workshop, folks. That workshop's going to be a week from today. Dow Industrials right now up 35. NASDAQ down 16. S&P's down 2.5. Gold's up $59. Silver's off $1. King Dollar up 606 ticks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 25. We get the Nasdaq down 23. S&Ps are up about 4.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento. And folks, every trading day, Larry has a great program, 9 to 10 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Fibonacci 24/7. Now, we got a real treat coming up. Larry did this about a month and a half ago. Bottom line, got to not only trade a lot of trades, show people how markets like to move. Larry's going to be doing a live webinar. It's going to be a live trading webinar, folks. It's going to be a week from today. You can sign up for this right now. The cost is $295. Larry is going to be going from 9 o'clock in the morning to 2 in the afternoon. That's where the action is. That's the real bottom line, folks. And what you're going to get here, you not only get his newsletter, it's a $97 value. You're going to get the full workshop. Larry's going to be talking about the advantages of using the ABC structure, the best time of the day trading, three patterns that are going to help you identify shifts in supply and demand. But let's bring our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento, on. He can actually get it right from our man's head. Right between the ears, Larry, as you said. You were saying that this morning. That was awesome.
Hey, thanks a lot, Tom. I appreciate the promo. But, you know, we did this back on May the 21st, the first time we've ever done it. And the response was so great that, you know, we are going to do it again. And it's really, you know, enjoyable to me and also very rewarding to see so many of the people that signed up for the first one, you know, coming to the second one. You know, we made, I believe, $1,700 on the five trades that we did. We did two stock trades, and then we did three futures trades. And then we did a lot of teaching in between because, you know, I use the harmonic numbers quite a bit. I also use the opening price. I show you the three main patterns that I look at, not just the Gartley and the butterflies, but the 1-3-5 patterns that determine the trend for the day. And when you add that all together, you know, 7 hours go so fast, it's like a blink of an eye. I mean, it was so fast, I couldn't even believe it. And the response, as you know, Tom, was just really very rewarding for us because yes. When people appreciate what you do, you know, that's really, you can't really put a dollar value on that. And that's what was fun. I don't make money every day, but I can certainly nip away at it as well as most. But the things that we teach, you know, are applicable to just about anything. And we do follow a few of the ETFs like GLD and the silver and stuff with, you know, you had a $70 swing in gold today from high to low, which was not unexpected because, you know, we hit that fib point of 618 last night and down she went. So we got a lot of support coming in at the gold at 1800. But getting back to the day trading thing, you know, you can't trade you know, 3 and 4 days at a time when you're doing a day trading show like this. So what you have to do is you've got to pick the most volatile things that you can look at with the least amount of risk. And that's the idea,
right?
Is to find out whether it's the S&P that day or gold, or it might be, you know, might be wheat. You know, who knows what it could be? It could be Apple. Apple's having tremendous moves, you know, intraday $7-$8. But when you got a $460 handle, that's not really much. But it gives you, you know, good opportunities to get in by looking at the patterns. And that's what the whole structure is, to show people that they can do this themselves if they practice it at home enough. And that's why it's a lot of fun.
And what happens, folks, the way that Larry sets this up and educates, okay, Larry is an expert patent recognition expert. Now, I know my Boston accent with patent gets kind of weird, but the bottom line is that what's so cool about it, folks, is that when you set these up, what you have is that you can basically wait for that to develop, which is really cool. You know what I'm saying? Well, of course you know what I'm saying, Larry, okay? So you have the number, folks, before the equity or the future gets to that number. And then the bottom line is you sit there. Patience is the name of the game. It gets there, guess what? And if you've listened to Larry's show, you know he's got an outstanding show, but you've probably also heard his little timers that go off. Well, his little timers that go off, okay, bottom line, that's when his trades are setting up. So it's a really great way of trading. It's a very disciplined way of trading. And, you know, Larry and I, we do the same thing over and over again. So it's pretty intriguing in the aspect of if you actually want to learn different setups, you know, you're not going to get clouded with a huge amount of stuff, you know. You know, Larry, what drives me, it doesn't drive me crazy anymore, but, you know, years ago, when we, you know, we'd be doing workshops, or, you know, we both wrote books and all this, and it's like, you know, sometimes people say, well, hold it, what about this and what about that? And I says, man, I'm sorry, I just do the same thing over and over again, man. I mean, it is what it is. I know, but it's, you know, it is what it is. And, you know, and it's not, what happens, folks, is that whatever you're comfortable with, that's the name of the game. But when you get into markets and you get comfortable with markets, most of the time you find what works for you. That's what it comes down to. So, you know, come over to our website at TFNN. Yeah. You're going to see it right on the front page. It's only $295, and you're going to get a great newsletter. And now that, you know, the newsletter itself, folks, is $97. So you're going to get the newsletter for the full month. You're going to get a week from today. You'll be rocking and rolling with Larry, and you'll see these setups. And we certainly have had markets that just want to climb higher. But you, with that being said, you can see just with the Federal Reserve coming out with the minutes today, all they did, folks, is that they said that they didn't say inside those Federal Reserve minutes how many bonds they were going to buy. And the market freaked, like, really quick, because that's what's no doubt been keeping the bond market up. You know, so I mean, if you look at the bond market, it's been a straight line move since March 25th, you know, so gonna be wild. Well, Larry,
that's for sure. Hey, listen, thanks for having me on today, Tom, and I hope the folks can join us on the 26th of August. It'll be a lot of fun, and may God bless and be safe down there, my friend.
Hey, listen, congratulations. I heard, so your daughter was born today, right?
Yeah, 52 years ago, I delivered her. I pulled her out from her.
I didn't realize that you were basically, so when you were going to school, you were nursing too to pay for school. Is that what you were doing?
I was a scrub nurse, and I delivered four babies in the emergency. Well, I delivered one in the back of a pickup truck. Tom, that was the funniest one. It was the very first one that I did, and the lady weighed about 270 pounds, and I was shaking like a leaf. And she had a towel with me. She said, just don't drop him. And I said, how do you know it's a boy? She says, the other nine were all boys. And then so I knew I was in good shape.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she had 10 kids.
Larry, it was so cool about that. I mean, you know, a couple of years after that, you know, guys were around, you know, delivering babies. But in that time, man, that was almost unheard of, man. So that is so cool. Yeah. You had that experience with your daughter.
Didn't have any choice back in 1961, but I had a choice back in 68, and it turned out okay. So
that's awesome, man. Well, listen, man, you have a great one, a safe one. Of course, we look forward to the show tomorrow, and we look forward to the workshop coming next Thursday, man.
Okay, thanks a lot, Tom. God bless.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. And it's real easy to get into the workshop, folks. You just come over to our website at TFNN. You are going to see it right under featured content. I'm Mr. Larry Pesavento. He's going to be doing that workshop at 9 o'clock in the morning to 2 in the afternoon. And if you haven't listened to his program, folks, please do. And in that context, okay, as all you folks are listening, we appreciate all the support you have given us. Okay, we've grown tremendously, as other broker-dealers have and since COVID started. Okay, they're good numbers. Number one, I want to thank everyone out there. And number two, please tell three people about TFNN. Bottom line, tell them to go to YouTube. Tell them to search TFNN, and please tell them to subscribe. It's free. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials are flat. Nasdaq's down 28. S&Ps are up 7. We'll come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff, as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now down 14. You get the Nasdaq off 34. S&Ps are off 8.5. So let's go take a look at the S&Ps first. What you're going to see out here, this is a little bit early to go after this swing low. So it looks to me like, number one, you're going to go after it. But number two, actually, just in the break, it just broke it. What I expect you're going to see here is that you are actually going to break this, not just break this one. This S&P looks like it wants to get down to the low of yesterday, which is that 33.65. We hit 33.76. We just did it when we were just talking about our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento. Now, you can see what it did here is this, folks. So watch how these high volume lows or highs work. The high volume low that was hit at that 220 mark had 72,000 shares traded. Then you bounced and you got up there with 67,000 shares traded, but yet you were going into 73. That doesn't work. So then we just came down. You came down with lighter volume, 44,000 versus the 56. You got a little bounce going, it'll attack it again. That's how these things shake out. And what is laying down here is that low of yesterday. If we go into the NQs and we do the same exercise inside the NQs, what you're going to see inside the NQs is that they haven't made it down to that level yet. And that when that happens, this is what's so cool about, I think it's so cool about how you can look at the NQs as well as the S&Ps, and you're basically lining them up and say, okay, has the NQs hit? Well, no, they haven't. So this is a huge advantage, meaning even if you're a bull, the way that would be set up as a bull is that you don't bite at this particular point. The reason being is that you just had the S&Ps break the low. The NQs haven't done it yet. The bottom line is that I suspect it's going to go after it, number one, but if you want your reward to go up and your risk to go down, that would be the level that if you're a bull, you'd want that to go down. You don't want it to reject lower price. Then you basically got action. And, the way that this market has been trading for quite some time, of course, as we come into the close, it's a sacrilege if the market does not run higher into the close. We'll see if we get this out here today. Apple, as I said, Apple's up $2.40 trading 464. Let's go take a look at Apple, because Apple does continue to run all the indices, and where Apple goes, the indices go. We're hitting all-time highs out here today. Apple was up at 468. You're at 464 right now. The amazing thing about Apple, folks, and the indices, is that Apple only has to move 4 points in order to basically move the S&P like 10 and move the NQs about 25 or 30. So it is a monster number. And when Apple decides to come down at $10 or $15, it is going to be a real problem child inside of the market in general. College football, you talk about, this is going to get really interesting, how for a long period of time, you've had the college players, wanting to basically get more than a scholarship, okay? What you have happening out here right now is pretty wild. There's a great article in the Wall Street Journal yesterday, and what it was about is that the colleges for forever have been claiming that the bottom line is that they don't have to pay student athletes. Why? Because the bottom line, they give them a scholarship. Well, the numbers that are out here are dramatic. You're talking about these big colleges, folks, bringing in 120 to 150 million, okay, on college players. And now what I expect you're going to see once COVID is over, you're not going to be able to have it both ways. The bottom line is that what their colleges are saying is that, okay, hold it. We got to cut this. We got to cut that because we don't have college football. Well, guess what? You can't have college football without college players. So I suspect that you're going to see that change very, very quickly. It's pretty amazing how the NCAA actually has got away with not paying for, number one, college players. The thing that's amazing business-wise is that, picture this, you don't have to pay for the talent. You don't have to pay, no matter what other business. It'd be like being in the pizza business. You don't have to pay for the dough. It's like, are you kidding me? So we're going to see things change. What has also happened out here, particularly with a couple of the big schools, Notre Dame being one of them, and I love watching Notre Dame. Bottom line, though, is that they basically are saying that, okay, listen, we got to close the schools, but we're going to open the football fields. And the three of the top schools are doing that, folks. The bottom line is you get Notre Dame, Michigan State, and the University of North Carolina. They're pivoting to remote learning, as many schools are. But guess what? They want to open those stadiums up. So that is really wild, because then I couldn't imagine paying $40,000 or $50,000 to go to school, and you're going to be virtual school. It's like there's a disconnect. And there's been a disconnect for a huge amount of time anyway, in the context of what is that actually piece of paper worth. These poor kids that are getting out of school the last 10 years, the bottom line is that you get a college education, and many of them, can't get a job that basically pays a decent wage, you know? Engineers, nurses, you know, the bottom line is if you do have children that are going into the school, you better make sure that they have a profession, because other than having a profession, that piece of paper, you might as well just put it up on the wall and throw dots at it. You know, that's, except if you were, right, a large Ivy League school. There's no two ways about that. Dow Industrials right now down 17. Let's see who's hitting the Dow in DU, because what we had out here is this. So, inside the Dow, because the Dow was up pretty good earlier. Nothing big, man. You get Walmart putting 15 negative points, Home Depot 10, Travelers 10. You get Visa up putting 19 positive points, Goldman 17, Apple 16. So, no big numbers there. We go take a look at the NDX 100. Inside the NDX 100, you get JD.com is up 3%, Regeneron up 2.4%, you get Moderna up 1.6%. Taken away from it. BioMarin's getting smoked. That's down 36%. Big number there, man. We'll go back to that in a second. Gilead's down 4.6%. You get Ross Stores off 4%. And you get Biogen down 2.7%. If we go back to BioMarin, this is like, wow, man. I mean, these biotechs, there's no doubt. You know, when they basically go topside, they go topside in an incredible way. When they go downtown, man, they just fall out of bed. BioMarin closed yesterday at $118, opened this morning at 85, goes down to 75. We take a look at this, you bring this back, and you're going to see this is trouble in paradise, man. You had the first high in BioMarin, goes all the way back to 2015. That was at 151, and gets smoked down to 62. We get all the way up to the price point of 131 last month, and now you are coming down with monster volume. So what you'll see here is that BioMarin will go back to the consolidation, and it's a very large consolidation. That consolidation, so 62 is the number inside BioMarin. And what we had out here, it's like, so BioMarin gets a setback in the hemophilia community. So bottom line is that, so BioMarin says FDA issued a complete response letter to its biologics license application. For several hemophilia drugs, the FDA introduced a new recommendation for 2 years of data from the company's ongoing 270-301 study phase three to provide substantial evidence of the durable effect using annualized bleeding rate. So bottom line is that it's bad news for BioMarin. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's down 59. Nasdaq's up 47. S&P's are off 13. You get Cudwell out there, folks. Larry Cudwell saying that the administration is working on a payroll tax deferral. Bottom line, folks, payroll tax deferral is not going to do a thing. I can't picture a company going along with it. The reason being, picture what a payroll tax deferral is, folks. It would be that if you're running a company, the bottom line is that you're mandated to not only take the Fed's taxes out of your payroll, then the employer also has to pay another additional about 6-7% on top of that. And that is one of the taxes, folks, that if you are ever late on one of those taxes, that is the easiest way to go out of business in about a second. So picture if you had a company that did go along with it, meaning then do you know what the company has to do, folks? Is that if the employee doesn't pay back the taxes because it's a deferral, the company's going to be on the hook for it. It's not going to fly. It is not going to fly. It's not even close either. I mean, because I think anyone that runs a company knows that the easiest way to get on the wrong side of the IRS is because they call it theft, you know. This is what ends up happening, too, by the way. That if you don't pay your payroll taxes, the IRS considers that theft. Bottom line, so it's a no starter. It's pretty amazing. Cudlow himself pushing that out and basically thinking that folks are actually going to believe it. It's amazing. Dow Industrial still down to 39. You get the S&Ps. That's going after that lower swing point from yesterday. We get the dollar still higher. So let's go back to the euro. Let's go take a look at the euro, because I suspect, no doubt, the euro as well as the euro gave it up. So bottom line, you had the breakout yesterday. You pull back today. That's saying the euro, we're at 118. That's saying the euro can go back to the lower end of this, which is the 116. We take a look at the British pound, and what you're going to have here inside the British pound is that is trading 131. And same type of setup there. You know, we had broken out yesterday. Bottom line is that you're pulling back now, and the pound can get into this 129. We go take a look at the Japanese yen. So the yen out here, folks, is that as the yen goes higher, it gets weaker against the U.S. dollar. And what you have with the yen is that rejected lower price out here today at the price point of 105.10, and you're trading at 105.98, and that's saying, hey, the yen can go back up to the highs, which is the 107.05. So we definitely have lots of movement out here inside of those currency markets, and I expect you're going to see a lot more of it. You know, between the currencies, between the notes and bonds, and what you have between the metals. If we do go over, you know, and take a look at this TLT, the TLT is actually set up. So watch what's happening with the TLT. So this, the TLT is the 20-year plus bond fund, ETF. Well, what you have here is this. When we came down last week, you got down there with 12 million shares. 163.16. That was the number. What you did out here today is you actually, you got higher than yesterday, but the TLT is going to need more volume to get basically break that level. Because when you take it and you put your crosshairs on it, what you're going to see is that the TLT is also going into 17 million shares. So I can understand where you're going, Jeff, that, you know, get the peanut butter and jelly out, get the cream cheese out, it's toast. But my take is that it's not toast yet. And the reason being is that you're going to need a lot more volume, number one, and price destruction inside of that TLT. If we go take a look at the 30-year bond out here, we pull a 30-year up, and we take a look at the 30-year. What you're going to see is the 30-year right now. It's down 17 ticks. We get 336,000 contracts, which is an expansion of contract volume, but same deal, you're going into 380,000. So I suspect that what it's going to do is going to go after that swing low. That's how this is shaking out. It does want to go after the swing low. And the bottom line, we'll see whether it holds it. What we are going to get out here, I suspect tonight and tomorrow, you are going to get a lot of these analysts in a monster way analyzing those Fed minutes and why the Fed basically didn't have in there the amount of bonds that they were going to continue to buy. Because what they also had in there, folks, is this, is that they had, I'd been talking about this the last few days. They've been doing a study, and the study's supposed to come out in September. And the study had to do with the aspect of how they were going to explain to all of us, number one, why they want 2% inflation, and number two, why they think they want to push that up higher than 2% and let that baby fly. You know, they also said inside of there that that may get postponed a bit also, which is really wild, because what had happened is that on Monday, yeah, today's Wednesday, on Monday, that started getting leaked out into the press through the Journal, through the Times, that, you know, this is going to be a big paper that's coming out explaining how they are looking at inflation. If we go back to the markets again for a second, the bottom line, let's go over to the NQs, because the NQs, they last time we were over there, they hadn't hit that high volume low yet. Okay, so you're going after it right now. So right now you're down $90. The high volume low is 11,311, and you're at 11,317, and you're at, so watch how this works. Let me get this closer. You get, this is coming in with, okay, so volume there is 9,400. Yeah, you're going to 28,000. Well, it's going to need more volume to blow this up, to blow this away. It's going to go test it. That's the bottom line. It'll do the test. We'll see how this shakes out. Because what is dangerous is that, watch how this works. On the 10-minute bar, if you're watching my screen at Tiger TV, folks, these are 10-minute bars I use. When you come into a high volume low or high, and you don't bust it on the 10-minute bar, meaning that you stop right before it, this is like a daily, that gets really dangerous, because then you have an additional bar that's starting right at that level. And what ends up happening there, of course, once you bust through it, you will get an acceleration on the way down. So we just busted it, the bottom line. Now the bulls and bears are going to fight like crazy. To see, can you hold that in the next 10 minutes? And what I suspect we're going to see, as I said a little bit earlier, though, that 268, right now you're at 313, 268, 11,268 is game in spades for the NQs. The NQs, folks, can move like a track star, okay? The bottom line is, if you ever hadn't traded the NQs, man, they are just something else, particularly on the way down. They just get, when they get taken apart, man, they get taken apart so fast and so furious. It's pretty amazing. Dow Industrials are down $1.20. Nasdaq's off S77. S&Ps are off 21. You get 10 minutes to the market close. You get the 25 minutes to the futures close. They're going to put some juice in this on the way down, folks. We'll come right back.
back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 83, Nasdaq's off 64. S&P's right now are down 15 and a half. And the big number out here after the close today, folks, is going to be NVIDIA. Bottom line, NVIDIA number one's been on a tear. They, you know, bottom line, are looking to take $3.7 billion in to the top line and $1.97 into the bottom line. And then it's going to be like, what is the market going to do about it once it comes out? The reason that NVIDIA is so important is that the chip sector in general, folks, can take that market up, take that market down in about 2 seconds flat. What you do get have out here is that, which is sacrilegious, there's no doubt, we get all red, which is unheard of, and you get Apple that's only up 49 cents after it hit the bell at the 2 trillion mark. So what you have with Apple out here, once again, you get a tight spread out here. You got over the little doji that we had out there on the 13th. We had 52 million shares there. So that was 464.17. And guess what, folks? Apple has a failure on price, failure on volume. Now, what does that mean? That means that you get over the high, you close under the high, you don't have the volume. And if, in this case, you get 20 million shot. Now, it only means that Apple can get out of the lower end of this consolidation it's in. But that lower end, if Apple actually goes to 436, which we were at 6 trading days ago, you will see some fireworks inside of the S&P, inside of the Dow Industrials, and inside of the NASDAQ futures. Why? Because that weighting structure, as we said, when Apple is a $2 trillion company, Bottom line, it has an outsized weighting in all the indices. And that makes a huge difference. As I said plenty of times, Apple can move 4 points and put some monster juice inside those indices. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows, and whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Folks, everything we need is right inside us. You might as well have a blast with it. Yesterday's gone, tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Guess what? Have a blast. Come back and visit us tomorrow. Tommy kicks us off 8:30 in the morning. Great show. Bam! Look at him, folks.